lateral view is taken. So you can see this sclerotic area in the medullary cavity, which is the cortex, periosteum, cortex, endosteal one. And within that lower one third of the femur, there is a sclerosis is seen. So what it has demonstrated is the lower the femur sham bone showing a sclerosis around the calcified lines. And the particle thickening and a diffuse medullary sclerosis also noted in this particular
இங்கேயும் தலை நல்லா தெரியாது இங்கேயும் தலை தெரியாது
நாட் தட் மச் வெரி கிளியர் ஸோ அப்படியா சிசிடி கரோனல் செக்ஷன் ஆஃப் தி ரைட் சைடு வேர் இட் இஸ் சீ தட் ஸ்க்லீரோசிஸ் ஆஃப் தி மெடுல்லரி கேவிட்டி அண்ட் தி சென்ட்ரல் ஏரியா தட் நைடஸ் இஸ் சீ ஸோ தட் இஸ் டிபிக்கல் ஆஃப் அ ஒன்ஸ் யூ டெமான்ஸ்ட்ரேட் அ நைடஸ் தென் இட் இஸ் டிபிக்கல் ஆஃப் அ ஆஸ்டியாய்டு ஆஸ்டியோ So that is why here CT is the most investigational choice for this osteoid osteoma. It is a circumscribed annular lesion and a calcified nidus is seen within the annular lesion. And the MRI also done for this patient where you can see this nidus here. White one is the nidus and surround its sclerosis is appearing as the elbow distal syndrome. So that is the distal one third of the shaft of the femur. The center of the lesion is also a hyperintense on T1 and T2 and the evidence of a diffuse intramedullary edema and the adjacent medial coronary particle pain, all these causes the pain. So final diagnosis is intramedullary osteoid osteoma of the right distal shaft of the femur. Ideal will be plain x-ray. After that, you can see the nidus and the sclerosis. The MRI also can be looked at. So this osteoid osteoma, it is a benign peripheral neoplasm of an unknown nature. It is composed of osteoid tissue and woven protein. Sometimes this isotope scan, this is a different patient, there the cortical osteoid osteoma showing, this is in the cortex, not in the medullary. The previous case was the medullary, this is in the cortex. This also will cause a severe intense pain will be there. And the isotope will pick up this one. And another case, here the vertebral osteoid osteoma, this is the nidus insert. And the presented is a severe blowback, sharply demarcated radial from nidus and the osteoid osteoma extending into the left pedicle. This left pedicle also is extending. So, which investigation first you have to do? First will be the radiograph, initial examination, suspect that for the osteoid osteoma. Then you do a CT scan. That will show you the precise localization of the nidus. And it is useful for guiding the percutaneous ablation. Now the latest one has come as the radio frequency ablation. I will just explain what is the radio frequency ablation. And the second and the MRI will be useful, but CT is superior for this demonstration of the nidus. And the radio nuclear scan, that is the technetium 99 diphosphonate uptake, also show intense activity at the site of the osteoid osteoma. So treatment is usually will be the surgery, N-block resection of the osteoid osteoma with the nidus. Now the latest one is the radio frequency thermal ablation. Just like in a house we are having an oven. So we'll pass a needle inside and then adjust the heat so that it will burn that tissue and then pain will be completely subsided. 100% proof will be there and the cure will be there in case of the osteoid osteoma. See, this is where one case is there. Here you can see this osteosclerosis and the nidus is there. That needle has been introduced into that. And then this is the radio frequency ablation machine where you can adjust the heat. Once you heat the thermal heat when you put it, and the needle is also adjusted. Go on increasing it. At one point of time, body level it will burn completely. It will burn up the nidus and the sclerosis also will come down. and the total cure will be there. That is percutaneously you can do.
Differential diagnosis between osteosarcoma and osteoma?
Osteosarcoma, very osteo reaction, onion peel appearance. Because multiple, because it's a sarcoma. You will see on the cortex and the periosteum level, you will have a multiple layers, like when you are peeling onion. That is what that is, description is, the onion peel appearance. That is classical for a osteosarcoma. Lower end of the femur, upper end of the tibia, that is the classical side. This one will be either intramedullary or cortical lesion. Nidus, demonstration of a nidus is for the osteosarcoma. Whereas in osteosarcoma, there will not be any nidus. Soft tissue swelling, periosteal reaction will be there. That way will differentiate. And it will be on a children, 12 years, like that age group will be less than 20 years, warm. And the tenderness will be there, preceded, osteosarcoma preceded by trivial trauma. There will be some trauma will be there. But here, it is there for 6 months and all. But pain intensity will be increased in osteodust. Whereas osteosarcoma, trivial injury, fever, constitution symptoms will be that way, it will differentiate even sarcoma from osteosarcoma.
What will be, suppose if he is not treated, what will happen?
So the pain, intensity of pain, you will not move that one thing, you will go for osteoporosis. That bone will go, you will have a severe pain because the lower one, because that is the classical side. Lower one third of the thigh or the lower one third of the leg, there it will come. So you have to treat it, otherwise they will not use it, they will have a severe pain. Just like they are walking on the thorn, like that they will feel, they will tell, I cannot do any work at all. So disuse osteoporosis will take place in the bones.
How much temperature do you
No, that depends upon you. See, it is 100 to 120
centigrade.
Yes, centigrade.